Last week, I toured the antique collection at Shanghai History Museum. Today, I will take a closer look at some of its modern exhibits. As the city enters the contemporary time, the collections witness the rapid economic development and ebb and flow of political powers. We could really see the city of Shanghai has transformed from a small fishing village to the economic capital of the Yangtze Delta region. I heard this bronze cannon is an important object here at the Shanghai History Museum.
Yes, it is the only bronze cannon excavated in Shanghai and it weighs 3 tons. It is the evidence of the Wusong battle during the First Opium War.
Okay. When was this discovered here in Shanghai?
It was discovered in Wusong in 1984.
Okay, not so long ago.
Yes.
We're looking at two soda bottles. I heard Shanghai was the first city in China to produce soda. That's very interesting. Maybe because Shanghainese are leading the trendy lifestyle in China, so that was produced in Shanghai first.
These two bottles are from the brand Aquarius, and it built its first soda factory in Shanghai in late 19th century, and the museum collect these two bottles in 1950s. We still have this brand in Shanghai nowadays.
I can see dust on the top of the metal cap of these two bottles as traveled in time. So a total of 58 songs are being collected here, and you're still collecting more.
Every day, many elderly people come and tell us, you should collect my school song.
So do you know when was the first modern school that was established here in the city?
It was in 1850, and it is nowadays Xuhui Middle School.
Okay, it's the school that we just listened to their song, okay.
Yes, and it was called St. Ignace School. That's for teenager boys.
Boys only?
Boys only.
Okay. We're standing by this wall of security boxes. I wonder what's being stored inside.
You can find some money used in Shanghai throughout history.
Wow, okay. I see some coins coming out.
Yes, these are Mexican silver dollars, and they were commonly used in late 19th century.
19th century?
Yes. Okay. And in 1850, the Qing government asked local merchants to make their own silver coins.
Okay, those are the coins from the Qing dynasty, I can see. Yes. It's written there in Chinese.
However, because of their easily imitated, so they are soon abolished.
Okay. So different appearances of money being shown here.
Yes. These are common copper coins used in daily life.
Okay. How much does it worth?
1 cent.
Oh, 1 cent. Okay. While it seems complicated to learn the long history of Shanghai through books, touring the Shanghai History Museum might be a more interesting way for you to learn and understand more about the city you're visiting or living in. Remember, admission is free, so don't miss it.